Students, is it visible to everyone slide? Slide is visible to everyone. Is it? My voice is audible?
सर थोड़ा इंटरफेरेंस आ रहा है बीच में से। हाँ
क्या प्रॉब्लम आ रही?
पर एक खाई पी चॉइस आ रही है बीच में से ही।
क्लियर है अभी?
हाँ सर अभी क्लियर है थोड़ा।
Yesterday's class, so given some introduction about the subject data analytics. Today onwards, we start the actual content given in the syllabus. So first, as we discussed yesterday, the first unit it contains the introduction to the big data, and as well as the next part is life cycle of the analytics, data analytics means how to we can do the analytics, so and what are the steps contains in the process of data analytics. So we go for first part, it is introduction. Because I already told that this data analytics is basically used for the data when it is in the huge amount. If it is in the small amount of, then it is not necessary to do these tools. So because of the data is in the huge, so then only we can go.
Just wait for a few minutes. Okay, right now it is audible to everyone. Is it audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. Now we can start. Okay, okay. So, big data, it is nothing but the data which is in the any large amount of information, large amount of the large amount of the data. We can say it is a big data. So, but how this big data will generate? Where is the sources? What are the sources that particular data will generate? Here, if you see that, the first two, just some few examples for you see that where this big data will generate. First, you see that credit card companies. So generally, we can use one credit card or maybe two credit cards. Some people, they will use more than two credit cards also. And also for each credit card, so it contains so much transactions. So within one day or within just 1 hour, so they will do a lot of transactions. So here, the credit card companies, so they have to identify the immediately. So which transaction is successful, which transaction is not successful, which transaction has some problem. So for that, immediately we have to identify that. But if you see that the credit card company, so it cannot contain so only just a few minutes, immediately few minutes within they have to give the feedback. So they have to give the result. So, but how can that particular company, it will give so that transaction is successful or whether the transaction is failed, immediately it is giving. So, but how it is happening because of analytical data analytic tools. So it identifies immediately which transaction is failed, which transaction is successful. So that, so you can easily, so identified by the customer, it will be easy to identify. So like this, if you see the company, so credit card company, so it contains a lot of transactions, huge amount of transactions. So it is not only contains one card information, it contains so many, so lakhs of cards information, lakhs of transactions information. So in that way, so the data fetching, it is very difficult. Monitoring the data, monitoring that particular huge amount of data, so it is very difficult. That's why, so we need to go for the so data analytical tools. So this is just one example. Another example, if you see that mobile phone companies analyze calling patterns. Calling patterns means which area may which on which area that call is getting, on which area the call is not getting, or busy, how that particular cell tower is getting busy. So in order to identify all these things, so we need the analysis. So for that also, so we have to use some so analytical, data analytical so tools itself. So because of mobile phone companies, they contains a lot of information, because we each and every second, so many phone calls will be recorded background. Okay, so which phone number is calling to which phone number, and counter time mein call kar rahe. So and what is the tower number kya hai? So counter mein source of the tower and the destination of the tower. So like this, the means node, we can actually technically call it as a node. So every data, it will be automatically records at background in the database, and as well as we need to analyze that particular so large amount of database. So in this case also, it is required for analytical, so data analytical. And some, if you see that right now, so many social network is there. So in this social network also, so very huge amount of information will generate. So in order to analyze that data also, is required so the data analytical tools. So means these are the some few sources, so which is generates the big data. So Next, we go for what are the attributes define big data characteristics. So here, big data, it is contains some particular characteristics. So otherwise, we cannot say it is a big data. Okay. So big data, it should contain some characteristics. Otherwise, we cannot say it is a big data. So just by taking small amount of information for small amount of database, we cannot say it is a big data. So it should contain some characteristics in order to recognize that particular data as a big data. So what here, some of the few characteristics are given. One is that particular data, it should be in the huge volume. It should be in the huge one, not just thousands or millions, but billions of the items. It should contain billions of the items. Then only we can say it is a big data. So otherwise, if it is in the hundreds or thousands, even lakhs items also be there. So then we cannot say it is a big data, because this particular small amount of information, lakhs of data items, it can be easily arranged. Easily we can analyze by using some small amount of tools. But when that particular data, it is in the billions, then definitely we have to go for big data, and we can call it as a big data. We need to go for the sub big data tools. By using big data tools, we can fetch it. And next one is, so that is the first characteristic of the big data. Second characteristic of the big data is complexity of the data types, or complexity of the data structures. Okay, complexity of the data types means some data, it contains text data, sometimes they contain the image data, sometimes it contains the voice data, also sometimes video data. We contains a lot of variety of data it contains. Okay, so the data, this is only four categories. Generally the data is in categories. One is the text data, second is voice data, image data, and video data. So, but these particular data also, it not contains in the small amount, it contains a large amount. Okay, so in that case also, complexity, various complexity of the data types and as well as the structures. So we can say it is a big data. So a simple data type data, simple data, we cannot say it is not necessary to use big data tools. Okay, so when it is complexity data, then we can complex data, then we can say it is a big data. Because so simple data structure data, so we can easily analyze by using any small tools. But when it is in the very complex data, very complicated data, then we cannot able to use to basic tools. So that's why we required big data tools to analyze the data. So this is the second characteristic of the big data. Okay, first one is huge volume of the data should be contains. Second one is the complexity of the data, it should be very high. Okay, we cannot able to analyze the data, that type of data we can call as a complexity of the data. Various sources say I'm data mangta. So then we can say various sources. And the next one is the speed of the new data creation and grow. Speed of the data means, for example, if you see data which is generating at the university site. Suppose if you take our SPPU university database. So in that database, the data will generate. Okay, but data will generate, but it is in the very low, slow velocity, with a slow velocity, because of very few students are there, and frequently we are not have touch with the database. So only at exams time only we can have touch with the database. So in this case, we cannot say it is a big data, because so big data, when it generates, when the big data will generate, every second, within every second, at the high velocity data, if it is generating, then we say it is a, it is possible to generate the big data. Okay. So yes, 1 minute. Okay. So this is the main third characteristic, means that particular data, it should be generated with a high velocity. So for each second, so it should generate so lot of information, and it is very fast. Fast speed भी ज्यादा होना चाहिए, means जल्दी जल्दी से जल्दी data collect करना है, and with high speed, so then we can have the chance to maintain the big data. Okay, so these are the main three characteristics, so that we can say it is a big data. One is the huge volume of data. Data should be contains huge volume, big size. Okay, होना चाहिए. Second is the complexity of data, variety of data, and some different formats में जो भी generate होता है वो पूरा data भी होना चाहिए. That is second characteristic. Third characteristic is the speed of new data creation. Speed of new data creation and grow. Grow means the increasing rapidly. Increasing the data rapidly. So in the so database. So this is also be third characteristic. So these three characteristics are there at a server side, then we can say that particular system is generating the big data. It is generating the big data. For example, if you see the Twitter server, or generally if you take the general Google server, Google server, it contains bigger and bigger the data, because within every second it generates the so huge amount of information, and speed also means so within 1 second a lot of information, and if you see the within 1 hour it will contains also be so lot of information it creates. Okay, so that's why we can say it is a big data. And also the Facebook social network, and also WhatsApp social network, it is also comes under the big data. So huge volume right there, and complexity data right there, means it contains image, text, video, audio, sub data is mein rehta hai. And the speed of means within a second the lot of information generate hota hai, so rapidly generate hota hai. So then because of these three characters, so we can say this is a big data. Okay, and some more attributes are given, some more attributes we can say it is a means generalize, technically generalizing this three characteristics as volume. Volume means the size of the data, and second is variety. So as we discussed, okay, just that same general things are we are making as a just a characteristic, whether it's a variety of data. And next velocity of the data. Velocity means with high rate generate hona chahiye. So with slow rate generate kiya to, so the data which is generating with very slow rate, there we cannot say it is not possible to generate a big data. Okay, so it will take some days to generate the big data. Okay, if the velocity is very less when it is generating the data with a less velocity, so it will take some days to generate the big data. But big data, when it is generates when that particular data is generating with speed, high speed, so it is possible to generate the so big data. So these are the main three attributes. These are the characteristics and attributes. So we can say it is a generalized things we are getting into the so characteristics. Okay, so velocity, volume, and variety. These three are the main three characteristics for the so big data. Now, what is the important of the big data analysis? Now we seen that what is big data and the characteristics of the big data. So now what is the necessity of doing this big data analysis? What is the necessity for doing the analysis? Okay, so we generating the big data. So by using some variety of data we generating and with very high speed generate kar rahe and with large amount of data we generate kar rahe. So ye sab kuch hum generate kar rahe server mein. So then what is the importance of the analysis? So generate ho rahe, data store ho rahe, data access kar rahe log. So system is working properly. So then, so what is the necessity of doing the analysis? So where is the analysis part? Okay, so because if you see Google, so in the Google itself, we are accessing our data, we are storing our data, and we are doing so much operations on our data. And we are not getting any problem at all. And even if you take the Facebook, so social network, it is also giving the chance to generate the data, storing the data, downloading the data, uploading the data. So as well as we are can able to share the data also. Okay, but the system is working properly. But what is the necessity of the analysis? We are not doing any analysis as a end user point of view. So on the social network, we are not doing any analysis. Just we are utilizing that services. So post, so store करना है, share करना है. अगर कुछ video share करना है, तो share कर रहे. But we are not doing the analysis. But what is the necessity of this analysis? Basically, this analysis purpose is so background business purpose के लिए analysis करना पड़ता है. Business हमारा business improve करने के लिए. For example, suppose Facebook company, if you take Facebook social network, so उनका business develop करने के लिए ये सब कुछ background big data analysis करना पड़ता है. So what is the necessity is to analyze and improve the business. So product उनका जो भी product है, भी Facebook का product है, वो Facebook का product improve कैसे करना है. So because users experience लेना पड़ता है, users experience लेके सो उसका सो सबसे हम डेटा डेटा एनालाइज करके उनके सबसे हम सर्विसेस इम्प्रूव करना पड़ता है, सिस्टम इम्प्रूव करना पड़ता है. सो फॉर दैट पर्पस द बिग डेटा शुड बी एनालाइज. ओके, सो हियर सम ऑफ द सम एडवांटेजेस आर गिवन इज व्हाट इज द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ डूइंग दिस एनालिसिस. सो हियर फर्स्ट वन इज द कॉस्ट सेविंग. सो कॉस्ट सेविंग इज nothing but as I told that business. Suppose if you are not using any analytical tools, aapka system hai, system mein data generate ho raha hai, big data generate ho raha hai. So big data ko aap manually analyze kar rahe, for example. So what is the, suppose if I want to identify the customers which are interesting on the particular item, so us कस्टमर्स को कितना कस्टमर्स है. सो आई वांट टू आइडेंटिफाई दैट पर्टिकुलर डेटा. सपोज इफ यू टेक एग्जांपल ऑफ ऑनलाइन शॉपिंग कार्ट. ओके, सो ऑनलाइन शॉपिंग कार्ट में सो मेरे को ऐसे आइडेंटिफाई करना है. सो कुछ आइटम ज्यादा कस्टमर्स लेता है. सो आई वांट टू आइडेंटिफाई दैट पर्टिकुलर सो आइटम. सो बिग डेटा में वो आइटम कैसे आइडेंटिफाई कर सकता है, सो दैट वी कैन इम्प्रूव दैट. एंड इम्प्रूव करने के बाद उस आइटम को रिलेटेड जो भी आइटम्स है वो भी हम इसको इम्प्रूव कर सकते हैं, इंक्रीज कर सकते हैं. सो सो दैट द बिजनेस विल डेवलप इट. बट मैनुअली इफ यू डू दिस एनालिसिस, फॉर एग्जांपल ये वो आइटम है मैं मैनुअली वेरीफाई कर रही, तो इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट, इट विल टेक्स वेरी टाइम कंज्यूमिंग. सो इफ यू यूज दिस एनी एनालिटिकल टूल्स, बिग डेटा एनालिटिकल टूल्स, सो दैट इट विल so generates the so analysis very fastly. So that it is cost saving hota hai. Suppose manually if manually 10 employees are working on that particular doing analysis, so if you use the tools, then only one employee it is required. Okay, so if you want to do it same work by using manually, it will takes 10 employees. But if you use the analytical tools, so it will takes only one employee. So means we are reducing the cost. Okay, so and it will improve the business also. Okay, immediately we will get the so data analysis data. So that is the first point. That is the importance of that doing analysis. Cost to saving. That is next to time reducing. Automatically, so if you use the analytical tools, so it will also reduces the time. Okay, it helps the business analyzing data immediately. So we can get the immediately the analysis. And new product development, naya product develop karne ke liye bhi humko so chance milta hai. If you do the proper analysis, so we can identify the so new products, which products hum naya improve karna hai. जो एग्जिस्टिंग उसको इम्प्रूव कर सकता है अपडेट कर सकता है बट एज वेल एज पैरेलली वी कैन आल्सो द इम्प्रूव द आवर बिजनेस बाय डेवलपिंग द न्यू प्रोडक्ट्स आल्सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट एनालिसिस सेइंग दैट दिस पर्टिकुलर आइटम इज हैव द हाईएस्ट सो परचेजेस सो दैट अलोंग दिस प्रोडक्ट यू कैन आल्सो नीड टू डेवलप द सम मोर प्रोडक्ट्स रिलेटेड टू दिस ओके सो लाइक दैट वी कैन गेट द reports. So that is the advantage of the so big data analysis. Okay, time saving, that is the first thing, then cost saving, time cost, and as well as it will gives the for new product development and understands the market conditions. Next one is we can analyze the current market, how it is. Okay, so which customers are purchasing which items. Okay, so we can understand that so market, current market mein kya chal raha hai. So otherwise kya hota hai, companies most of the companies are failing. Okay, even if you take some big companies, multinational companies also, they failed to run the business. For example, if you take Nokia, so because they are not understand the current market. करंट मार्केट में क्या चल रहा है, करंट मार्केट करंटली व्हिच इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द कस्टमर्स, दे आर नॉट अंडरस्टैंड, बिकॉज ऑफ दैट ओनली दे आर फेल्ड. सो इन ऑर्डर टू सो नो द करंट मार्केट, सो इन ऑर्डर टू अंडरस्टैंड द करंट सो सिनेरियो इन द मार्केट, सो डेफिनेटली वी हैव टू यूज द डेटा एनालिटिकल टूल्स. डेटा एनालिसिस, बिग डेटा एनालिसिस करना पड़ता है. Okay, so that is another advantage and importance of the data analytics. Next is control online reputation. So online reputation control bhi kar sakta hai. Okay, so these are the some so points, important points, important things are there why it is required for doing the data analysis, what is the necessity of doing this analysis. Okay, so first is cost saving hota hai, time reduce bhi hota hai, very quickly hum we will get the reports, and as well as by using these reports we can identify which item is having highest priority and which items are newly we need to develop. We can understand that new product development ke liye, and also we understand that current market trends kaise chal rahe hai, मार्केट में करंट ट्रेंड्स कैसे चल रहे हैं, कौन सा ही चीज के ऊपर करंट ट्रेंड चल रहा है. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट वी कैन चेंज आवर बिजनेस. सो लॉजिक्स, बिजनेस हम चेंज करना पड़ता है. सो फॉर दैट आल्सो इट इज वेरी यूजफुल, एंड आल्सो कंट्रोल ऑनलाइन रिपुटेशन. ओके, सो दिस इज द मेन इम्पोर्टेंट ऑफ द बिग डेटा एनालिटिकल्स. बिग डेटा को एनालिसिस किया तो क्या फायदा होता है. If you see current scenario, in the current scenario.